Absinthe is the aphrodisiac of the self. The green fairy who lives in the absinthe wants your soul.
Generator. secret and I will run until I reach the shore. I've known it all along. Like the bone under my skin. Like actors in a photograph. Like paper in the wind. There's a hammer by the window. There's a knife on the floor. Like turbines in darkness. Like the blood on my door. It's the generator.
Open your eyes, see the lights right in front of you. anything as long as it's mine. And the door it opens way back in, or is it way back out? Any place is where she'll be, any place she'll see you from. Lies and secrets become your world. Anytime, anywhere, sticks me away. And that climbs up the steps one by one to give you the rose that's been burned by the sun.
Misfits on Widdershins.
Widdershins
Radio. And I think we heard Lords of the New Church before that, Bad Religion before that, and I think The Damn with Absinthe starting off the show. Partying Like Us, 1895 to Absinthe.
1899.
Yeah. So, We just found out. I just found out. I don't know. Maybe Marta knew, but it showed up in Marta's memories that we were doing this show called Widdershins a year ago. Popped up on Facebook. So I went and I looked. I looked through the archives. Sure enough, we started doing pilots around July 7th, I believe it was. Did several pilots because they were like 15 minutes long. I think three or four pilots, and then our first official broadcast. July the 11th. So we're actually like a day early for our birthday, but July 11th. It is now July 10th. And that was July 11th, 2017. Here we are, the anniversary of this odd little show that we randomly decided to start one day because we were bored. I mean, it had a lot going on, crazy shit going on, but somehow we had this little piece of boredom. I said, hey, let's start a podcast. Marta says, yeah, it's called Widdershins. Took off.
You had some dumb name that you wanted to call it.
Yeah, you always say that, but you never can conjure up the dumb name.
It was too dumb. I blocked it out.
Well,
some like long wordy, something about stirring the pot or something like that.
Marta, are you going to throw me under the bus right away? So, in kind, I'll have to throw Marta under the bus right away because it's been a year now. And maybe there was one very labored attempt, but we still have not heard the long-awaited segment from Marta. Stupid shit my president says.
That's too much work.
And there's, I know there's too much work, but it is a year now. A year. You couldn't just like, you know, sort out like couple things? I mean, narrow it down?
No.
Round it off?
No, because then it would be old news by the time I had read it a year later. Duh.
Well, yeah. Well, that, you don't. I didn't say wait a year.
You said a year later.
But I mean, it says so much dumb shit every day. You can't just like pick out three things in a day. Just like today.
Yeah, with all my free time.
You know you're reading that shit. You're reading that news because you tell me about it. You tell me stupid shit that our president said every day. And, you know, he's giving us no shortage.
Well, he picked a real winner to nominate for the Supreme Court today.
Yes. Tell us about that.
I don't remember if he actually said anything stupid, but he, oh, God, what's the guy's name? Kavanaugh? Brent Kavanaugh? Something like that. But this guy wrote some paper in 2009 about how the president should be above any kind of investigation and that it's a waste of time and bad for the country. Meanwhile, this guy was Kenneth Starr's right-hand man when he was investigating Clinton. So, I'm sorry. Do you think they should be above investigation if they're Republicans? Is that what you're trying to say? Because you investigated this other president, so I don't even get, but totally understand why Trump is nominating him, because he doesn't want the investigation on him. Ding, ding, ding.
Go figure.
Yes.
All right, well.
And.
That's some stupid shit.
Today was the deadline to reunite all the kids under age 5 with their parents who were separated at the border. And they're estimating that they're about 100 kids under 5. And today was the deadline. And exactly 4 were reunited. So they don't even know where these kids are. They don't even actually care where they are.
They got more kids out of the Thailand cave than that.
Yeah. Yeah. Jeez. Like a couple weeks later.
So, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. It took people's kids and then lost the kids. And these are the people that are going to be like still throwing Pizzagate out there. It's like, you know what? If anybody's abducting children, evidence seems to point towards Trump and his people. Who knows where those children are ending up. And there have been talk about, like, they want to do DNA tests to figure out who their parents are. I don't even know what that's about. It's shady. It seems shady that they want to do DNA tests. But they took all these children and had no fucking plan how to reunite them. But they had a plan how to take these kids away from their parents, lose them in some fucking foreign country where they don't even speak the language. Oh, God bless America. God bless America. Wittershins. Been a year now. We were bitching about that shit when we started this show. Still bitching about this shit. Let's hope we won't be bitching about this shit on our second anniversary. We'll have other shit to bitch about. Wittershins. See, we started a... We kind of started as a news show, and then we moonlighted as a gossip show. Definitely been a music show. A talk show with guests. So who we had? We had our dear friend Candelo on. Candelo Cambisa.
Yeah.
Ambrosine Laguerre.
Who
San Moise. San Elias, just had last week. Darren Asbjorn, King Asbjorn Butte Torval.
Yeah.
And the Tim Ravenroder. They had it out on the air. Who else? The
Christian Day.
Christian Day. That was an epic half-ass, like very, very low tech. It was very low tech. No, but well, I was just trying to get the audio quality. Like, it was low tech as hell. I stuck my phone up against a laptop and Skyped him in. it was good enough. Not great sound quality, but good enough. Joseph Robichaud.
Yes.
And who's that?
Thomas Fowler.
Thomas Fowler, yeah. For the Nazis in Salem thing.
Yep.
The Nazi store in Salem. They're at Nazi. I think that was Nazi Witches Fuck Off. Uh-huh. Episode 1.
Yeah.
Yeah. We had to have 2 or 3. Do we have 3? Yeah, I think we had 2.
I don't know if we had 3.
I think we talked about the subject again. Yeah. You know, we had another thing with some Nazis, but it wasn't good enough or big enough for a Nazi Witches Fuck Off episode 3. So as such, on Wittershins, I've assembled a little bit of pagan news that I thought was interesting. I'll read you one, and probably one of them will go to a break. Let's see. Actually, we haven't been talking that long yet. Well, let's see. I saved these stories. And these, I was just poking around like I do for, you know, pagan-related news.